So, welcome everyone to Operation Wolf Mother. We are nearing the end game. We have upgraded nearly all of the weapons, of the standard weapons, with the exception of the heavy gun, which is currently still in research. We definitely need the plasma. Very, very bad, because we are now already facing the hardest enemies, or partially the hardest enemies in the game. In our case, sectopods. We do not have blue screen rounds yet, but we are researching it at the moment. And as soon as this is going to happen, we can finally also get blue screen rounds or EMP grenades. This mission here is going to be exceptionally hard, mainly because we are on a timed mission, so it's going to be dangerous to pull this one off. And at the same time, fighting a sectopod. We're fighting 13 enemies here. So this is definitely not going to be easy. Not at all.
Advent already knows we're here, so your position isn't concealed for the extraction.
Good. Here we go. So again, four men teaming. We are not using any of the special items. I'm specifically not using them in missions where we could lose them. And we want to make sure also that we get out of here as soon as possible. Like, we do have a VIP, which naturally tells us that the VIP is going to take the lead here. Again, not being concealed means that the VIP needs to do the scouting. One move. Good evening, Kozjorik. And welcome, buddy. Good to have you on board. Second move. VIP hasn't scouted anything, so apparently, there is nothing. Which would be good news, to be honest, so we can go on just a little bit further.
Double time.
Perfect opportunity for us. I mean, it's not that far away, but we're still going to have quite a long way to run. So I'm just putting everyone here. Again, we're not concealed. And that's the first pack that we're facing. I said overwatch shot, but unfortunately missed.
Won't happen again. Enemies on the move! They're flanking us! Got some advent here.
Good, and now we are in trouble. See, that's exactly the disadvantage of having that many enemies and a sectopod in here. Gosh. So we will need to use our actions to their fullest potential. We do have a hack here. Let's see if there's anything that could help us out. Again, checking it doesn't require any other actions. Reinforcements would be our certain death now, so we're not going to take the hack here. We could go for serial, just out of interest, like 100. Yeah, we're having good chances of hitting these guys, and we would do also decent damage, so need to keep this in mind. If we're, for instance, opening with a plasma grenade, we'll still have an action left over. Like plasma grenade could remove the cover here, damage these guys, also shred a little bit, and the damaged guys could be instantly killed by the serial. It will not help us with the sector pod though. We need to take care about him separately. We do have 1-2 mimic beacons. We could go for a face off. Not a bad idea to be precise. Not a bad idea. Or alternatively, we'll go for the normal kill with her. So I would say let's go for serial. If we can kill 1-2, take a couple of free shots onto him, 3, so that would mean all of his bodies are down. Then it's only the sector pod. We can kill this guy here with our shotgun, so that would mean he's down as well. So it's only the sector pod and the Andromedon. The Andromedon is very dangerous at its current position, because if he launches up something up here, we're actually in a really bad spot. So we do not want to have that happening at all. We do have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 shots theoretically. And we could hit all of them. Plus we could get 8 protocol and threat assessment. Okay, let's do it exactly as we were planning to do it, right? So we're starting to soften them up. Salvo allows us to take a grenade and still take an action afterwards. Good. These guys are severely hurt. We can now take another action. We're taking serial to clean up. Again, she's going to make sure that this guy here is going to be significantly hurt without pulling something else. On your order. The sniper is going to be the one actually throwing the mimic beacon. Great. Target eliminated. That was a nice little crit. With the upgraded shotgun, by the way, it's perfect. Like, really, really good. Good, so I was talking about softening up the guys. I'm not sure if we can soften up him enough. Like, we would do a lot of damage with our free shots, but I don't know if that's going to be enough. We would need to have 2 shots and get him down to, far enough down so we can kill him with serial to get all of the free action shots. So Elite Lancer, it's the first kill. Well, let's actually start with Elite Trooper here. First kill. 9 damage. Good. The Lancer is at 2, 4, 6, 8, 9. And if we're looking at the damage, we have not a guaranteed kill on him. So what I want to do is I want to soften him up so we're getting definitely a guaranteed kill on him. He's now softened up and poisoned, by the way. Okay, with a crit we would have had a kill anyways, but it's good to still have these options. Again, we do have two rounds left over, and what I want to do here is I want to 8 protocol. What's her vision? She can see him and him. Okay, that's good enough for me. We want to 8 protocol her because we do have threat assessment, so she will get an extra overwatch shot and she actually deals the most damage. That will not stop our turn. It's just a normal action. Good. We now have the option to either kill him or soften, significantly soften up the sector pod. And despite the fact that I like the idea of softening up the sector pod, I like it a lot. I feel it's simply more efficient to shred him and kill this guy down here. The alternative would be a frost bomb. Let's think the frost bomb through. No, we don't want to do that at the moment. No. Let's see, shredded. Enough to take damage. If we're lucky, we can kill him. If we're not lucky, it's still okay. Because he's going to burn. We have incendiary rounds. But we're okay on the damage. Good, we're still going. This damage would be neglectable. I'm thinking about repositioning. Not a bad idea. Question is if we can shut him down. What's the chance of shutting him down? 50-50. We're going to mimic beacon anyways, so how about we're just trying to shut him down. Come on. Oh, so close. So close. Fortunately, he's now having higher defensive stats, but he's super easy to hit, so that's not a loss.
No problem, boss.
We are going to use the mimic beacon like here. And our VIP is just getting the fuck out of here. I want to lose her accidentally, so hunker down. Wow, even more enemies. Not a good sign. Nice little hit.
Armor still holding.
Solid damage. All right. So we can freeze him and him, which would enormously reduce the pressure for the next round. It's basically then only these guys, and I think we're going to do that. Question is, I mean, we could go for a chain shot afterwards. Like, what's the chances? Still 100% great. Okay, because then we might be able to. I don't know. I don't know if we can still kill him. We don't have blue screen rounds with bonus damage. That would be okay, but we're still not. I'm still not sure if that's going to work out. Again, we don't have that many other options, and I feel at the moment that the frost bomb will not hurt us. It won't do anything bad to us, so. We're taking the free shot here. And now we definitely need to shred the sector pod as good as we can. Good. Shredded and fully shredded. That's good. Great, to be honest. We don't want to stand in the open. Half cover is poor cover, but it is still better cover than none. The sector pod will have one turn, and we will definitely need to aid protocol. The Andromedon will be taken out of the equation. We could go for a kill on him. I don't feel it's very clever to toy with a sector pod. Sector pod can one-shot the mimic beacon, and we're having three guys back there that will take additional shots on the mimic beacon. So if we can kill one of them, it's not a bad idea. Let's go. Wow.
Target still up.
Of course. Let's still follow our idea. Nice. I could have used this execute on the sector pod, to be honest. But yeah, shit happens. Second mimic beacon. And we don't have any chance to even start moving over there. But I feel once we killed most of these guys, we should actually be fine. Out of four packs, I think we already encountered three here at the beginning. Nice one. It missed. Good, so that's one more, and there's the last gun. Again, we want to maximize the damage here, so I'm going to remove all of the cover. This is the only damage that Smolcher will do this turn, because he will probably lob the last mimic beacon. We could go for a face-off. I don't know, that's four targets. And if we play our cards right, we might be able to kill some of them. For instance, this Advent mech here. That will die. Good chances to kill the Andromedon as well. But face-off is only three targets, so are we preferring four shots with a gun, which is 3 to 6, or are we preferring one big shot, which is 8 to 10? No, I think the many shots will deal more damage overall. He still has one armor, but I guess that still holds true. The other alternative is to go for a sniper shot, but that's not really a clever option. We also do not have serial yet. We don't have another 8 protocol. We used most of our skills. We're really lacking damage at this point. So we need to start killing guys. If we would focus on the sector pod, is there a high chance that we're actually going to kill it? So it currently has 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 22. Oh my god, the standard is display is so bad. 24, 25, 25. Minimum damage 8 plus. That's nearly. That's 8 if we're unlucky. 8, 16. If we're really unlucky, we're talking about 23, so he would still be alive with 2 HP. So are there any no regret moves that we could take? For instance, if the shotgun crits, we can kill the sector pod. The shotgun doesn't crit, we need to come up with a different plan. This here is basically going to kill him. That could also be a nice little other option, like just removing him. But the sector pod counts for 2 shots and he has 2 extremely hard hitting shots. Haywire is also down. Shit. Not enough damage to kill the sector pod right away. I hate that. We can kill this and this guy, and we do have sector pod plus 1. Sector pod will do the first turn. Yeah, I guess that's the safer play. If we kill these two guys, then we're going to end up only with the sector pod. The sector pod takes 2 shots at the mimic beacon. This guy can take 1 shot, but he does not throw his grenade. This guy can definitely use his grenade, so we can't let him survive. That wouldn't make sense. Good. So let's maximize the damage, like I said. Starting with the pistol damage. And we're now facing off. Unfortunately, he survives with 1 HP. Good. Like I said, we can't let the mech survive. And we can't let the Andromedon survive either. The Andromedon's body is not a problem for us because it doesn't have enough movement to get up and hit us. And it will probably also go for the Mimic Beacon. Good, last Mimic Beacon. From now on, there is no more Mimic Beacon. This is ridiculous. All of the packs start to engage one after the other, and we're in this it feels like we're in this zone where everyone's like taking their extra shots over and over and over and over and over again.
Menace 1-5, be advised, hostile interceptors are inbound on your current position.
Firebrand. Ridiculous.
Is a limited window to provide extraction.
Good, so we need to kill the sector pod this turn. Let's start focusing him down. Nice little execution. Good, we can furthermore give ourselves a protocol. Which will allow us to take multiple Overwatch shots. Plus, we might be able to kill him. Nice. Nice, lot of executions, executions here, right away. I'm worried about not getting to the evac zone, but it's effectively 3 rounds, so we still have more time. We just need to kill that goddamn shell here. And get far enough away from one another so it's not going to hit multiple guys from the rooftop, because when it hits it's going to destroy cover and therefore the ceiling will break. And since it doesn't matter whom he's going to hit, I suppose. We go over here, try to kill it, and we do have an Overwatch shot left over. So, yeah, if he's going to move first, then we're having a good chance of killing it. Which doesn't solve the issue with the Archon and the Sectoid that are right down there, but it will help. And no, of course, he doesn't start first. Wow. 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 So he was hitting us from up there. He has hit himself down there. Great. That's so stupid. Even for XCOM standards, that's pretty stupid. I'm trying to find a position where we don't have to run too far. Like this here is not too bad with a sniper because he anyways needs to move. So this guy just literally fell through the floor. So we're going to lightning hand him. Finally killing him. And hopefully dealing some extra damage to the Archon as well. Archon is poisoned. We can hit from up here. That's good. So the chances of hitting the Archon are pretty good. We're having bad odds in hitting the sector though. So let's run and gun for now. I want to get the loot as well. So we're ending in the open because I know that there is no further pack. I don't have any issue with doing that. Superior outloader and a couple of other goodies. Asset in tow. Good, so we're not going to take a shot here. We're waiting. Maybe we can get the sector pod. I do not want to take any risk, to be honest, so maybe we're just healing ourselves up. And for now, let's reload and really kill the Archon. Good. Archon is down. And before we heal ourselves, let's just kill this guy down here, because that will be unnecessary bonus damage, which we do not want to take. So instead of healing up immediately, I've just waited a little bit. The sector will probably take a shot, but his gun is extremely weak. And yeah. Damn you. One civilian just ran through the acid burn of the shell. And the sector had fled, which tells us there's still one more pack, unfortunately. Matt Damon healing himself, at least up to a level where it's going to be okay. And we now need to start moving up. Sector takes some damage and... Damn it. I don't want to... No, I don't want to waste another turn.
Got it.
So we're effectively moving up and not killing the sector, probably. Or maybe we can. It depends a lot on whether or not we're pulling. I'm not a big fan with ending in the open, specifically not for a sector, right? So that doesn't look very appealing. So we're instead going for solid cover. Putting our VIP here, and Matt is going to follow us. Again, we are only effectively 5 turns away from ending this mission. There seems to be a last pack. Sector is down to 4 HP. Okay. One move. first move already would trigger. So 5 turns. We're talking about 1, 2, 3 turns, which means this turn is still going to be okay. Let's pull the pack here. Good, we can probably finish off one of them. Don't have enough movement to go for both of them. /50 and /50. Let's kill one of them for sure. Damn. Didn't work out. So I don't like opening ending in the open, like I said, but here's the kicker. We can't kill them fast enough. There is not going to be any happy ending here. So maybe this guy is going to retreat. Maybe we're taking one shot, which would not kill us. He's going to retreat instead. Okay. Even more. I don't know if we can fight all of them.
Good to go.
That's a ridiculous amount of advents. Wow. Wow.
Je m'infiltre dans leur système.
No, the reinforcements would again kill us. And I can't see how we're going to go through that next turn. That gentleman here is going to use shields on everyone.
On your order.
I can't deal damage this turn, not effectively. And our sniper also needs to definitely start moving. But we can't even exit next turn, not right away. That's fucked up, guys. I don't even think about killing him. I don't know, we could try to get him and then maybe we can kill him.
Got a piece of the armor. Almost out of ammo.
What's the furthest that we can go?
I can handle that.
Nope. If we could have poisoned him, that would have been great. Looking grim.
S05, hostile interceptors are on high speed approach. Your window for extraction is closing.
Let's start by getting the VIP out of here.
VIP récupéré et prêt pour l'extraction.
VIP is secure.
Could move up all the way up to here. Could go inside, which would actually be a pretty decent defense, and then from here get out of there next turn.
Let's do this.
Which is probably the right way to go. We do have run and gun, which would allow us to go inside here, kill this guy, and next turn take the stairs up and just leave. Reduces the damage by a lot. And we would effectively just, yeah, be seen by the sectors, and that's about it. But I'm not afraid about the sectors. I'm rather afraid about the rest. One of the sectors already used his mind spin, so he can't do it again.
Hostile terminated.
Good, we're moving over here. I know that we're going to probably take some damage, but we're probably also going to survive it. And we definitely need to take the maximum move.
Location confirmed.
So here we go. Yet another hit. Did he just crit kill me? I was so sure that he couldn't kill me, but he still critically killed me. Unbelievable. I can't believe that this really just happened.
Moving to position.
And I nearly would have taken a shot being outside of the evac zone. Luckily, we double checked. So from here, he would be able to reach that point. Let's double check. We're blue moving to here, we can still reach that point. Good. Let's pick up the corpse. Free action. Oh, really? As soon as you pick up a corpse, you're moving slower. At least this guy needed to double move. Yeah, the sniper, I don't know. A lot of bugs have happened with that sniper. I'm not happy with how this one turned out overall. I haven't seen the crit, so I can't tell for how much he actually hit.
Getting out of here.
But it felt like a lot. And we had only one more turn left over, so the only point of criticism that I could accept here is we could have taken the one turn to kill that guy. Which again is questionable because I don't know if we would have dealt enough damage to kill him in one turn. Pretty bad. Specifically because we just leveled up the sniper to, I think, captain. So losing him or her in this case is bad. I mean, next month we will get new opportunities to buy someone, and we might pursue on these opportunities, but I would have preferred to keep her because she already did a couple of missions. Yeah, rest in peace. 10 missions and you died by receiving a bad hit. That really sucks. She was captain, which means after captain she would have been major, so she was pretty close to becoming endgame material. And whilst we are now the proud owner of 115 Intel and an engineer, that Intel will probably go straight into a new soldier from the black market, because we just lost one. So congratulations, that was more or less an even trade. How many more days? Yeah, 2 more days and then we can buy something again. What was the sniper's special AWC skill? I think she haven't had one, so not a loss in this specific regard. We're going for alien alloys, and we needed to, by the way, do the mission because they, of course, did it in the area where our facility is, and we didn't want to lose that area. Good. GCP, congratulations, buddy.
Depending on who you ask, psionics could be considered the alien.
cool little outfit. I like it. So he just got the Inspire ability, which is great. Wow, so many cool abilities for him. Let's start with Soulfire. It's not so much about the special ability from the AWC, which sucks. I could have lived with her not having any special ability, but our plan at the moment is we really want to get a second team going, because that could have happened to anyone. And look at that, since I'm now playing from my home PC, we do have a couple of guys from the original campaign ready, a couple of faces from our original character pool. Look at that, gentlemen! I think we're going to be positively surprised, because... Oh no, we can't yet get her, but... We can already look at her. So a Major Ranger, Harley Quinn, without the face makeup, because we haven't installed any mods apparently, but it's still Harley inside her. It's still Harley Quinn.
Avenger plotting new course.
So let's get the supplies by Harley, and we will see if we can get a reserve sniper. I hope we can. Good. By the way, we got a lot of income now, 700 per month, which is great. So here we go. Oh, nice. All right, Sectopod, time for our revenge. I might say, time for our revenge. So let's continue with heavy weapons.
I'll send word when the project is complete. Hello, Commander.
Build items. Blue screen rounds. Yes, please. Let's take 2 of them. The other alternative could be that we're taking one EMP bomb with us, because that's really not that bad against sector pods. Like, shutting them down temporarily is a good crowd control, much better than taking a mimic beacon. So let's just build one for now. We might be forced to use them here in this specific run.
Welcome,
good. We take the Ranger, Harley Kinn. Congratulations. And let's see what's up. In the black market. And yay, blue screen rounds, finally. Good old blue screen rounds. So we can buy a major sharpshooter, Shang the Bang. That's fine for me. Sucks a little bit that she's going to be replaced that fast, but 70 intel, I'm not going to pass on that. And whilst we are on it, I think we're going to get a superior speed, because superior speed is seldom and we'll need it. Good. Let's welcome the new two soldiers here. Wizard 2020, aka Shang the Bang. He doesn't look like him because we don't have all of the cosmetic mods installed, but you can believe me, it's him. I'm playing the mod-free version still. And by the way, whilst we are at the mod-free version, since this is the original character pool, let me shortly add the characters here to the character pool. Falcon, yes. Anakin, yes. The Demigod, yes. Letus, yes. Lumberjack, yes. Blue Pancake. No, we have hundreds of Vorneis. We don't need her in the character pool. He's well, Vasipuken. I don't know. Let's wait. Abomination, the Dark Marcella. Let's add her as well. Mad Mad. GPC. B-Shift's alternative ego. No, and these are already in the character pool. Good. Let's promote the soldiers. Nice. She just got the ability Blast Padding. So, one armor point for free. Thank you. Cool. Not as good as Serial, but still pretty good. We'll go with Blade Master, Shadow Step, Run and Gun, Blade Storm, untouchable on her. And we will color code her. So Harley is back in business with her black gun. And let's give her a PCS. I think we can give her the superior speed that we just bought. Right? Yeah, that would make sense, because if she has Reaper, she will need to be fast. Good. And Wizard 2020. Promote Soldier. Your grenades deal two extra damage. Okay. Yeah, well, not the best ability ever, but I guess overall okay. Personal combat sim for him is going to be... Damn, I thought we had another... another good to hit. I don't know, we need plus hit on him. Whilst we are waiting for that, Let's not give him one. Yeah, well, we could give him plus two speed because we have that many of the lower ones. That will help him to get to his target faster. Good. Couple of majors now. And blue screen rounds. These sector pods will melt. I'm promising you guys, no more sweating with the sector pods. They are going to die. Good. We're continuing with alien alloys.
Avenger plotting new course.
And apparently, if we need more money, we could get some supplies. But I think the problem is going to be the Ilerium, really.
Resistance communications facility now operational.
Cool. We just got resistance comms, so we can now make contact to new regions again. And we can use our Advanced Warfare Center medic to help down here. Good. This will give us some sort of Ilerium, but I think not enough. Probably 20 or 30. Not enough, definitely. Because we're now nearing the point where we want to have the beam cannon. Good. Experimental heavy weapons, fine. We can wait for them. And yeah, we should be fine then. Time to one-shot the codices. Oh yeah. Good, that's the last of the big weapons. We finally got the beam cannon, which is great. So now we can think about which of the autopsies we need the most. I think we're going to start with Archon King. No, wait a second. Let's start with the sector pod, actually. I know that everyone wants to see the new armors, and that's fine, and we're going to get to that point, don't worry. But I really want to have the upgraded gremlins, so sector pod is probably the most important part. Blue screen rounds, grenades, we have them. Yeah, sector pod.
From what I've been told,
located. 55 alien alloys, that's good. So we're fine on... Oh, wait a second. Let's take a look. The weapon upgrade. So, weapons. I'm skipping Gremlin Mark 2, because I want to go directly to Gremlin Mark 3. And the beam cannon will take us 40 Ilerium. So if we can get a little bit more Ilerium, we should be fine. 38 Ilerium to go. Let's check the black market real quick, because that's the first place to get Ilerium, apparently. Buy. No! Well, it's better than no Ilerium. So let's get it. And we do have enough supplies, so the supplies shouldn't be the issue, but we are missing two Ilerium. Shit.
Just give the word and I'll get started, Commander.
Yeah, two Ilerium crystals. Sometimes it's frustrating. So close, but yet so far. And let me guess, no Ilerium to scan for. Nope. Yeah, well, we can get resistance contacts. But that's totally pointless because we can just upgrade our resistance contacts and then we have enough. Which means let's just get intel. Damn, I wanted to have the I wanted to have the upgraded gun so bad. At least the psi-operative training is continuing according to plan. Apparently, they are also training exactly the same skills, so they are pretty in sync with their training.
Alien facility coordinates locked in, Commander.
Good, we're now at 2. We soon need to get to the facility there. But I'm still hoping for some Malarium. Good, alien infiltrator. That's not a problem, but look at that. Enemy unknown means there's a gatekeeper on this mission. There's also a gatekeeper on this mission, and there's a gatekeeper on this mission. I knew they would come eventually. There's a colonel, Sir Letus. So it's the good version of Wet Letus, the original Letus, so to speak, Grenadier. Colonel Grenadier. That's actually pretty impressive. And it's only difficult instead of very difficult. And the other two are just supplies, guaranteed reinforcements, doesn't really matter. Plus it's protect the device, so we're never going to do that. But a colonel, a grenadier. The fun part about it is we don't even have a colonel grenadier yet. So that would actually then double the amount of Colonel Grenadiers in case we ever get one.
Commander Tigan and Shen aren't going to be happy if we don't put the Skulljack to good use. We should have one of our soldiers equip it before they deploy.
Good, we're going in with a major team here, which fills me with the expectation that we're going to win this one. We're not in for a draw or a tie, we're in for the win. MadMad with the blue screen, with the serial. I'm thinking about if he's going for a serial kill, if it would be really better that he takes the bonus damage from dragon rounds. Mainly because often the small enemies that you're going to kill are humanoids. On the other hand, blue screen rounds are so good that I see specifically when codices pop up, they are so good that I see no reason for not taking them right away. They are like extremely strong. So I guess I answered the question on my own. Wizard 2020 with his face-off ability. See, here's the issue. Venom rounds are cool if you're facing off and if you can kill everyone because they add one extra point of damage, which is great, don't get me wrong. But we're mainly having the problem of not being able to kill strong units, so we might want to go with the blue screen rounds here. And a mimic beacon, of course. Only thing that I don't like about him is we're not having a PCS advanced or superior perception for him. which sucks. I mean, the speed is okay, but his aim is still not optimal. Damn, we can't change it right now. It is what it is. I would take one EMP bomb. But let me think about it. We do have so much blue screen rounds now that maybe we're giving him one gas bomb, which will deal a lot of initial damage. Which will deal a lot of initial damage and could set up for the face-off ability. Well, that's a combination that we used earlier. Maybe that's going to work out good. We don't have a frost grenade, but that's okay. We don't need it. I wanted to play without the special items for the time being and see how the four-man squad performs without the added content. So we're having enough abilities against mechanical units. I'm not going for another blue screen round. It is preferable, in my opinion, to have something to actually one-shot their normal guys. And yeah, Ghost could one-shot them. Plus, she also has Shredder as her ability, so that's, I guess she's going to be okay. So yeah, this is it. Normal upgrade up. Everything seems to be fine. Here we go, guys. Here we go.
Sky Ranger deployed.
In position to drop.
I'm still thinking. There is... We know there's a one thing that I want to change. We know there is a gatekeeper. So we're taking a different grenade here, guys. Where is my acid grenade? Who stole the acid grenade? Latus, why the fuck do you have an acid grenade? Good, the reason why I want to go with the acid bomb here is its shredding capability is immense, and after shredding, the gatekeeper will not stand a chance against us. I prefer that even over the EMP bomb against the gatekeeper, because 7 armor are nothing to sneeze at. All right, here we go.